Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Pidato-pidato tadi secara umum memang sepertinya parlemen negara-negara OKI itu terjebak oleh tema yang terlalu dominan sekarang, yaitu terorisme, sehingga semua orang bicara terorisme dan seolah-olah terorisme itu berasal dari kalangan Islam begitu, karena bukan ini dari kita. Nah, kita harus positif bahwa kita punya narasi sendiri, yang narasi itu sendiri dari awal ya Islam artinya salam, artinya damai. Karena itulah tuduhan-tuduhan ini harus dibalik gitu. Dan cara membaliknya adalah dengan melakukan sesuatu yang konkret. Saya tadi mengajak kita lebih banyak mengembangkan kultur membaca agar hubungan dengan antara negara UKI di bidang pendidikan itu ditingkatkan, supaya standar pendidikan kita itu bisa lebih tinggi. Dengan standar pendidikan yang lebih tinggi lah kita bisa mencapai satu tingkat peradaban yang bisa menghindari tuduhan-tuduhan naratif yang ada dari pihak lain gitu. Saya kira ini tadi mendapat apresiasi karena yang lain jarang bicara seperti itu begitu tadi. Itu yang pertama. Yang kedua, soal pertemuan bilateral. Ya, dari semua pertemuan bilateral itu kita hanya mau menyampaikan kepada mereka bahwa Indonesia mendukung negara-negara yang kita temui ini, dan kita ingin selalu bersama mereka untuk mengkonkretkan kerjasama, karena mengkonkretkan kerjasama itu jauh lebih penting ya. Kita ngomong kiri kanan, tetapi kalau kerjasama antar negaranya terutama dalam investasi dan perdagangan tidak meningkat, ya tidak ada gunanya, karena itu kan ujung-ujungnya berhenti di bicara gitu. Tapi kalau kita mulai konkret, perdagangan kita meningkat, pertumbuhan ekonomi kita baik, kesejahteraan rakyat meningkat, pastilah hubungan antara rakyat dengan rakyat pun akan makin baik, dan itu akan meningkatkan kekuatan dari bangsa-bangsa itu. Saya kira itu pesan yang paling penting. Ya, itu misalnya ya, itu hampir tidak ada yang memuji Mali ini, padahal Mali ini dulu ada kerajaan Islam yang luar biasa. Yang saya baru tanya tadi, besok kita akan berkunjung, mereka punya perpustakaan yang berasal dari abad 14-15, yang dari Universitas Sankor, ya salah satu universitas terbaik di dunia pada waktu itu, masih ada 4.000-5.000 buku yang belum dibaca, ya, buku-buku klasik gitu yang diterbitkan pada tahun-tahun itu. Nah, ini harusnya kita memberi apresiasi dan membantu mereka untuk memiliki kebanggaan masa lalu yang lebih baik gitu, sehingga bisa mereka tumbuh menjadi bangsa yang positif ke depan. Sebab ancaman dan ajakan untuk menjadi teroris ini kan juga banyak, karena ini kan seperti ideologi yang dikampanyekan juga. Saya kira itu.
Excellency Speaker of the Parliament of the Republic of Mali, Mr. Issa Sidibe, Excellency Parliamentary Speakers, Member of the PYC, Honorable Head of Delegation, Honorable Parliamentarians, Distinguished UIC Secretary General Professor Errol King, esteemed audience and media partners, ladies and gentlemen, Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. First of all, on behalf of the Indonesian delegation, I would like to convey our deepest appreciation to the Republic of Mali for the warm welcome and hospitality, the initiative of the Republic of Mali to host this 12th UIC conference is an initiative I hold in high regard. I would sincerely believe that the Republic of Mali has done exceptionally well in the preparation of this conference, allowing the conference and its series of meetings to produce appropriate, constructive, and concrete result. This forum is also a showcase that Mali is not only a safe and secure country, but also very capable of taking leadership in international development of Oran as well as keen to move forward. Having Republic of Mali as our host is not a coincidence. Allow me to remind us that for several reasons Mali is one of the most important Islamic nations. First, Mali is the second largest country in the West Africa with 95% Muslim population of its 17 million people. Second, the Muslims in Mali are known as tolerant Muslims, similar to my own country. Muslims in Mali are open-minded individuals, and Muslim women take part in the economic, political, and social lives. Third, Mali has a history of Islamic civilization that needs to be preserved. In the 14th century, under the leadership of Mansa Musa I, Mali progressed and became one of the center of knowledge and science. At that time, the University of Sankor in Timbuktu was recognized as one of the most renowned and oldest universities in the world. At that time, the University of Sankor, with tens of thousands of students and libraries that were homes to tens of thousands of ancient manuscripts, set an example of how natural wealth was utilized to build knowledge and scientific civilization for the good and prosperity of many. Distinguished audience, the delegates and I cherish this opportunity to again be present alongside all of you and gather in this forum. Last year I was also attend 11th UIC conference in Baghdad, in Iraq. Today, once again, we meet to exchange opinion, to share smart practices, to contest insights and ideas, to arrive at a common sense and view for the good and benefit of the Islamic world in particular and the world in general. We are eager to see the world that is peaceful, prosperous, just and civilized. Last year I also spoke that one of the root cause of terrorism, which was global injustice, and the most of it happened to the Muslim and land of the Muslim. I call for the unity of the Islamic world because our unity will be a formidable asset. The Islamic world has a combined population of 2 billion people and a flowing abundance of natural resources. Imagine for a moment a time when we can truly optimize our human and natural resources potential and use them to fight global injustice. I believe that terrorism, global injustice, and division between Muslim populated countries are still highly relevant to be discussed. But let us ask some relevant questions. Who makes the most out of this conflict? Because clearly, we do not get anything but loss and misery. But those who trade in weapons and make the opportunity to exploit our natural resources and make the most profit from the void of power are clearly benefiting from the conflict situation. Honorable ladies and gentlemen, and it's our engagement in discussion and its narrative, let us take a moment to return to our original narrative. Islam is the narrative for the last day. Islam in Arabic means nothing but peace. And we should remember that let the world aware of the fact that Islam is the religion of peace. Islam inherently equipped with the ways to end conflict and mechanism to build peace as the model to us by the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The Prophet brought unity amidst strong tribalism in Makkah. With his leadership and wisdom and the teaching of Islam, we should follow his step and create peace and unity among Ummah. We should reject the idea that terrorism is rooted in Islam. specific narrative with positive message from the Islamic world. Again, I wish to call our unity and harmony. We need to see that unity and harmony will lead us to peace, stability, security, and situation that is conducive to sustainable development, thus allowing us to realize our prosperity together. I truly believe that this UIC forum can contribute can partake in the effort to bring about unity and community in the Islamic world, so that we as the owner of the past can own the future, especially by strengthening the shura among us. In the Al-Quran stated, وَأَمْرُهُمْ شُرُّ وَبَيْنَهُمْ. Here as a parliamentarian, we are expected to be at the forefront in the effort of promoting and developing the shura tradition. The parliament must be an example of how the values of shura are practiced, representing the people, engaging with the people. A parliament is strategically positioned to establish the shura principle. Let us strengthen our parliament and promote our democracy, as it is part of our Islamic shura tradition. Distinguished Elvin, as the final part of my address, I would like to share my great expectation toward the 12th UIC and the series of related meetings. This forum is expected to formulate concrete steps in the effort to unite all Muslim countries in the world. Let us promote a more concrete cooperation among the OIC member states. Our trade and investment should increase, and the level of education should be among the best. As I mentioned before about Sankore University in Timbuktu, in this country, at the 14th and 15th century, where books are produced and not weapons. With the spirit of our founding father, let us promote Iqra, reading, as it was revealed to us at the first surah. Iqra will always be the most important word for the Muslim. Thank you very much. Assalamu alaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.